So when we think landscape photography, our first impulse is to reach for a wide angle lens, something like a 1430 or a 1424, maybe even a 2470. And while I'll use those in all of my photography, there is a place for long lenses in landscape photography. Using long lenses in landscape photography can really help with your composition. What it does is it compresses the perspective. It brings things together. Really useful in woodland, mountain ranges, seascapes where you've got coastal cliffs and things like that. I've got the 100 to 400 here. This is going to be a great lens for landscape photography as well as wildlife photography and maybe sports. 70 to 200 f2.8 is also very, very good. Benefits of these lenses as well, if we want to extend the reach, we could even put the Z series teleconverters on them as well, the 1.4 or 2 times, depending on what your requirements are. So I've just come into this woodland, found this amazing location, perfect for long lens photography. If I use my wide angles, it's going to push everything away from me. It's all going to be very small in the frame. So this woodland needs to look really, really good. I'm going to use the 100-400 here. I've seen the shot I'm going to take, so I'm just going to wander over there and frame it up and shoot it with this long lens. One of the other uses for long lenses is isolating subjects. We've got this shot here at the lake, the castle here, the ruined castle on the island there, perfect, 400mm. I get the layers of the castle in the foreground and then those hills covered in mist and rain in the background, and it all pulls together so I get a really nice layered photograph. So we're en route to our final location of the day. As we're driving along, we've come across some Highland cattle. So I'm shooting handheld here. We're shooting very quickly because we're chasing the light. So I want to take this picture of this Highland cattle really, really quickly. I've got the inbuilt stabilization in the Z7 II turned on, which gives me a lot of flexibility with my shutter speed. So I'm shooting at 1/250th of a second, wide open at f5.6. I've switched on auto ISO, so my base ISO is ISO 64, and the ISO is floating up and down now. We've got a grey flat day here. It's going to be around ISO 5000, and I have no concern at all with that or the noise level at all on my Z7 II. It's perfectly acceptable to me. So the 100 to 400 compositionally allows me to do a lot. I can have the Highland cattle looking straight on at me. I can have a really, really good close-up shot. And then if I wanted to do perhaps a shot where they're in context of the surrounding tier, we've got the field, we've got the pine trees, we're in Scotland. So I can zoom back out to 100mm and get a contextual shot as well. So this lens offers a huge amount of flexibility when I'm composing my images, be it a landscape shot or a wildlife image. Having a long lens in your kit bag gives you a huge amount of creative flexibility when you're shooting. Strongly suggest try it if you haven't already. Put a long lens in your kit bag, go shoot landscapes with it. You'll be astonished with what you'll be able to produce. You'll get some cracking images.